Good morning dear students, welcome back. I hope you all are fine. Yes, students, today we'll start our next lesson. Our next lesson is lesson 5, measurement. Okay, our next lesson is lesson 5, measurement. Okay, so students, do you know what is the meaning of measurement? Do you know? Okay, I'll explain you what is the meaning of measurement. Okay, then I'll explain you some examples, then we'll start the exercise. Okay? Now students, I'll explain you what is the meaning of measurement. Measurement means kisi bhi cheez ko measure karna, napna. That is called measurement. Okay? So now let's see here. We measure things to know how heavy, long, tall, etc. they are. It means, students, measurement means to measure the things, to know how long it is, okay, how short it is, okay, how tall that thing, okay, how much heavy that thing, how much light that thing. So this is called measurement. Students, measurement means kisi cheez ko napna, measure karna, ki wo kitni long hai, kitni short hai, okay, kitni tall hai, okay, and kitni heavy hai. So students, this is called measurement. Okay, now I will explain you with one example. Now students, here I have two pens. Okay, now tell me which pen is long and which pen is short. Can you tell me? See, this is pink pen and this is red pen. So which pen is long? This pink pen is long, yes, and this red pen is short. So we can say pink pen is longer than red pen, yes, and this red pen is shorter than this pink pen. Okay, so students, this pink pen is long, okay, and this red pen is short. Okay, students, here you see, here two pencils are there. So this pencil is long, yes, and this one pencil is short, yes. Understood? Now students, look at here. So look at here, here are also two beds are there. So this bed is long and this bed is short. Okay, understood? Students, there are many ways to measure things. Students, these are the standard units of measurement. These are the standard units of measurement. Okay, we can measure the things according to the length. Okay, we can measure the things according to the weight. And we can measure the things according to their capacity. Okay, so these are the standard unit of measurement. Hum, students, hum kisi bhi cheez ko uski length ke according bhi measure kar sakte hain. Hum kisi cheez ko uski weight ke according, uske weight ke according bhi measure kar sakte hain. And uski capacity ke according bhi measure kar sakte hain. Okay, understood? Now students, let's measure the things according to the length. Okay, now let's see the example. Now students, let's measure the things according to the length. Okay, here I have taken one example. Okay, so students, can you tell me this is what? This is what? This is a whale. This is what? This is a whale. And can you tell me this is what? This is a goldfish. Okay, now you tell me, who is long and who is short? Can you tell me who is long and who is short? Okay, so whale is long. Yes, this whale is long and this goldfish is short. This goldfish is short. Okay, so we can say like this also. Whale is longer than a goldfish. Yes, and this goldfish is shorter than this whale. Okay, we can say like this also. Yes. Now students, let's start question number 1. Now students, let's see the first question. So the first question is, right, long or short. Okay. So here pictures are given and we have to see that picture is long or short. Okay. Now students, let's see the first one. Students, see, this is what? This is a pencil. Yes. And this is what? This is a crayon. Okay, this is what? This is a crayon. Okay, now tell me log. So here we write log. Okay. Yes. Now this crayon, it is long or short? This crayon is short. Okay. So here we write short. Now, understood? Now let's see the people. This is what? This is a car. Yes. And this is a train. Yes. Now tell me, this car is long or short? This car is short. Okay. So here we'll write short. Okay, now students, so see this train. Yes, this train is long or short? This train is long or short? This train is long. Yes, so this train is long. So here we write long. Okay, students, understood? Now students, let's see the next. Now students, let's see the next topic. So our next topic is measuring length using body parts. Okay, students, we can measure length of anything with the help of our body parts. Okay, but these are non-standard units. Okay, these are the non-standard units of measurement. Why we are calling them non-standard units? Because they change from person to person. Students, how many non-standard units do we carry? Because these person to person change. Okay? Students, when we measure anything with the help of our body parts, so they are the rough measurement. Okay? So now let's see how we can measure anything with the help of our body parts. So the first is hand span. First is what? Hand span. See, what we have to do? We have to stretch our fingers in this way and from thumb to the last finger. So this we can measure anything with the help of this. So this is one hand span. So now let's measure one thing. So students, I have one duster. Okay, so now let's see how we can measure this duster. So put your thumb on this point and your last finger on this point. So this is one hand span. This is what? This is one hand span. Okay, iski length kitni hai students? Iski length hai one hand span. Okay, now students, the next point is digit or a finger. Students, we can measure thickness of anything with the help of our digit or finger in this way. Okay, students, with the help of one digit we can measure thickness of anything. Like see, digit means the thickness of our one finger. Okay, understood? Now let's see the next one. So the next is cubit. What is a cubit? Students, what is cubit? How we can measure thing with the help of cubit? From our elbow to the middle finger. Okay, so this is cubit. Okay, see here, from elbow to the middle finger, so this is the cubit. Okay, now let's see. Students, this is what? This is a blackboard. So we can measure the length of this blackboard with the help of cubit. So see, put your elbow here and your middle finger is here. So one cubit. This is two and three. And this is 3.5. So students, we can say the length of this blackboard is 3.5 cubits. Okay. Now let's see the next one. So the students, we can measure the length of anything with the help of arm length. So what is the arm length? So see, from our shoulder to the middle finger. So this is किसी भी लेंथ को मेजर कर सकते हैं. ओके, सो दीज आर द नॉन स्टैंडर्ड यूनिट्स ऑफ मेजरमेंट और वी कैन से दीज आर द रफ मेजरमेंट. ओके, नाउ स्टूडेंट्स लेट्स सी द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. सो द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 2. मेजर द फॉलोइंग ऑब्जेक्ट्स यूजिंग बॉडी parts. Okay, use actual objects. So in this question, what you have to do, you have to measure the actual objects, okay, and with your body parts. Okay, so you can do this question at your home. You can use objects, you can measure the objects, okay, with your body parts. Okay, students, so maybe aapke answer mere answer different ho sakte hain, because mere hand span आपके हैंड स्पैन ऑफ क्यूबिट्स से. सी माय हैंड स्पैन इज बिग, माय हैंड स्पैन इज बिगर देन योर हैंड स्पैन. यस, माय क्यूबिट इज बिगर देन योर क्यूबिट. सो मे बी आंसर डिफरेंट हो सकते हैं. ओके, सो यू हैव टू यूज एक्चुअल ऑब्जेक्ट एंड यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट द आंसर. ओके, नाउ लेट्स द फर्स्ट वन. माय बैट इज डैश हैंड स्पैन लॉन्ग. सो आई कैन राइट आई मेजर एट होम एंड माय बैट इज 4 हैंड स्पैन लॉन्ग. हाउ मेनी हैंड स्पैन लॉन्ग? 4. स्टूडेंट्स यू कैन मेजर योर बैट विथ योर हैंड स्पैन लाइक दिस. ओके, सो माय एक्चुअल बैट ओके इज हाउ मच लॉन्ग? इट इज 4 हैंड स्पैन लॉन्ग. ओके, नाउ सी माय स्टडी टेबल इज डैश क्यूबिट्स लॉन्ग. क्यूबिट्स मीन फ्रॉम एल्बो टू मिडिल फिंगर. सो वी हैव टू मेजर लाइक दिस. Okay, so my study table is dash cubits long. It is 3 cubits long. Okay, how much long it is? 3 cubits long. So you can measure your study table at your home and you have to find out your answer. Okay, now let's see the next. Now students, let's see the next point. So our next point is weight. Okay, we can measure anything according to their weight. हम किसी भी चीज को मेजर कर सकते हैं उसके वेट के अकॉर्डिंग में. यस स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज ऑल्सो अ स्टैंडर्ड यूनिट ऑफ मेजरमेंट. ओके, सो स्टूडेंट्स हियर आई हैव टेकन सम एग्जांपल्स टू एक्सप्लेन यू ऑल व्हिच थिंग इज हेवी एंड व्हिच थिंग इज लाइट. ओके, सो नाउ लेट्स सी हियर. सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट एग्जांपल. यस, दिस इज व्हाट? दिस इज अ मेजरिंग स्केल. ये क्या है? ये एक मेजरिंग स्केल है. ओके, सो एट वन साइड ऑफ द मेजरिंग स्केल देयर इज अ बर्ड. यस, एंड दैट साइड वन फेदर इज देयर. ओके, नाउ यू टेल मी व्हिच वन इज हैवी. अ बर्ड इज हैवी और अ फेदर. टेल मी व्हिच वन इज हैवी. सो बर्ड इज हैवी एंड दिस फेदर इज लाइट. बर्ड हैवी है. यस, और फेदर, बर्ड का फेदर कैसा है? लाइट है. ओके, so we can say like this also, bird is heavier than a feather. Yes, and we can say like this also, a feather is lighter than a bird. Okay, yes students, one more important thing to remember is that the heavier side of the measuring scale always moves down. Students, measuring scale ka heavier side hamesha kahan hota hai? नीचे की ओर होता है. ओके, द हेवियर साइड ऑफ द मेजरिंग स्केल ऑलवेज मूव्स डाउन. ओके, एंड द लाइटर वन ऑलवेज मूव्स अप. ओके, जो हेवी साइड होता है मेजरिंग स्केल का वो नीचे होता है और लाइट वाला हमेशा कहाँ होता है? ऊपर होता है. ओके, अंडरस्टैंड? नाउ स्टूडेंट्स लेट्स सी वन मोर एग्जांपल. हियर आल्सो वन मेजरिंग स्केल इज देयर. यस, सो दिस साइड वन एप्पल इज देयर and that side one orange is there and that side one orange is there. Okay, so you see the both side is equal. Okay, the measuring scale both sides are equal. So we can say apple and orange have same weight. Okay, this apple and this orange have same weight. Okay, understood? Now students let's see the next question. So the next question is question number 3. Tick right the heavier one in each set. Students, you have to tick right which thing is heavy. You have to compare the things, then you have to tick right on that thing which is heavy. Okay? Now see the first one. See, in this first one, two things are given. First is a telephone, yes, and here this is a cloth here. Now you have to compare which thing is heavy. A telephone is heavy or a cloth here. Come on, tell me which one is heavy, this telephone or this a cloth here. So this telephone is heavier than a cloth here. Okay, so here on this will take light. So here will take light. Okay, understood? Now let's see the paper. Here two things are given. See, this first is pencil, the next is a book. So which one is heavy? A pencil is heavy or a book? Which one is heavy? So a book is heavier than a pencil. So here I put right. Okay. Students, how I have done A and B, in the same way you have to do C and D. This is your homework. This homework you have to do in your book. Okay. Understood? Now let's see the next. Now students, let's see the fourth question. Okay. So the fourth question is write heavy or light. Okay. Now let's see the first one. This is a peacock. Okay. And this is a crow. Okay. Now tell me which one is heavy. A peacock is heavy. Now tell me which one is heavy. A peacock is heavy or a crow? Can you tell me which one is heavy? A peacock or a crow? So students, peacock is heavier than a crow. Okay. So here we write heavy because peacock is heavier. Because peacock is heavier than a crow. So peacock is heavy. Okay. Okay. Now, students, crow is lighter than a peacock. Okay. So crow is light. Okay. So here we write light. L-I-G-H-T. Okay, understood? Understood, dear students? Now let's see the next. Now students, let's see the B one. Okay, so this is a bat. Okay, and this is a ball. This is a cricket ball. Okay, now tell me which one is heavy? A bat is heavy or a ball? Can you tell me which one is heavy? A bat or a ball? Students, bat is heavier than a ball. Okay, always bat is heavier than a ball. So bat is heavy. So here we'll write heavy. Okay, bat is heavy. So here we have to write heavy. Okay. Students, ball is lighter than a bat. So ball is light. So here we'll write light. L-I-G-H-T. Okay. Understood? Understood, students? Now let's see the next. Now students, our next topic is capacity. Okay? Students, we can measure anything according to their capacity. Students, हम किसी भी चीज को measure कर सकते हैं उसकी capacity के according. Okay? What is the meaning of capacity? Do you know? Okay, let's see here. Capacity is the amount any object can hold. Capacity means shamta. Capacity ka meaning hota hai shamta. It means capacity is the amount any object can hold. Koi bhi cheez kitna hold kar sakti hai, kitna amount hold kar sakti hai, that is called capacity. Okay? Now see, here I have taken an example. So see, this is a jug. Okay? And this jug can hold how much water? So a jug can hold 10 glasses of water. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay? Students, if we put all the 10 glasses of water in this jug, so this jug can hold all the 10 glasses of water. So this is the capacity of this jug. So we can say a jug can hold 10 glasses of water. Okay? Students, इस जग की कैपेसिटी है 10 ग्लासेस वाटर को होल्ड करने की. सो वी कैन से अ जग कैन होल्ड 10 ग्लासेस ऑफ वाटर. ओके, and we can say like this also, a jug can hold more water than a glass. Students, एक जग ज्यादा पानी होल्ड करता है एक ग्लास के, yes, and a glass can hold less water, yes. Students, a glass can hold less water than a jug, yes. एक ग्लास कम पानी होल्ड करता है एक जग के, yes. We can say like this also. Students, let's see the next question. So the next question is question number 5. This is the last question in your book. Okay. In each set, tick write the object that can hold more. Okay, you have to tick write on that thing which can hold more. Okay, you आपको उस चीज़ पे टिक करना है जो कि ज़्यादा hold कर सकती है. Okay, so now let's see the first one. Students, in this set, two pictures are given. Okay, so first is a bottle and next is a bucket. Okay, so which can hold more? A bottle or a bucket? Can you tell me? Students, क्या बता सकते हैं कौन सी चीज ज्यादा hold कर सकती है? Bottle ज्यादा hold कर सकती है कि bucket? Students, bucket can hold more than a bottle. Okay, so here I'll take right. Okay, understood? Now let's see the B one. In this set, two pictures are given. First is a glass and second is a cup. Students, a glass can hold more than a cup. Okay, glass ज़्यादा hold कर सकता है cup से. Okay, so here I'll take right on a glass. Okay, understood? Students, I am ending my class with this homework. So homework is page number 102 and 103. Okay, there is a heading, how much do you know? Okay, till now what I have explained you all the related exercise you can see in this heading. This homework you have to do in your book only. Okay, so we'll meet in next class with a new lesson. Till then, thank you so much.